This is Ryan Elliott for Boxing Social in association with Betfred. We're in Essex ahead of the Golden Contract Tournament Saturday night. With me in the tournament, Stephen Ward. Stephen, before we get down to boxing talk, how are you, mate?
Good, mate. Good.
Excellent. Let's talk about the tournament. How did this opportunity come about for yourself, and how quickly did you jump at what is such a huge chance as well?
It's quite vague, from what I remember, to be honest. It was after the Conroy fight. This team he was saying there would be an opportunity came up, and I came up and jumped at it. Why would you not?
Now, obviously, yesterday you picked Rikard Blachnik. Can you just talk me through that pick and what you expect from him as well?
Yeah, he's a good fighter, Blachnik. There's a lot to gain from fighting him. He's highly ranked. I had a good win with Russian the last fight. So he's no mug. I just think, do you know what? I just had a gut feeling. I looked up, there was a couple I was thinking about picking. And he was the one that just stuck out to me. I went with my gut.
Have you watched much of him since the draw that sort of reaffirmed that gut feeling?
Not really. I watched a little bit of him last night. I don't like to dwell too much. I leave that up to Jimmy and Edge. I think at this level, especially the quality opposition in this tournament, where you should be able to adjust, you know, to the person in front of you. You know, I think everyone should be at that level now. Obviously, you can have a look and get a wee bit of an understanding, but Jamie and Nigel do the main work behind the scenes, and they'll just be feeding me the information.
What's it been like for Jamie and yourself preparing for what is such a huge opportunity, potentially career life-changing opportunity, but not knowing who you face until fight week? Is it almost a throwback to amateur days, just being the best version of yourself and adapting come the time?
I've loved it. I think the reason being, you can just focus on your own performance. You can think about what you were doing wrong in previous fights and adapt that. So yeah, it's something fresh, isn't it? Like, it's something new, and it's good for the fans as well. No one knows who they're fighting until a couple of days before, and then all of a sudden, better fireworks.
How was that yesterday? I always think it must be really weird when you're all stood there, and I saw you all in your fight gear facing each other off. What was that experience like? It must have been bizarre, and I know you said you're enjoying it, but completely unique experience, I'm sure.
A bit different, just, you know, just something out of the ordinary you're not used to, which is good. Something different. You're standing there looking around. It wasn't until sort of 5-10 minutes before we'd done the draw. You just feel the tension starting to change. People get a wee bit tense about who they're going to pick and what if you're going to end up where. But it was good.
A lot of talk sort of going into the draw about whether we could see that rematch between you and Liam Conroy. It's been talked about a lot today. You did have the option to pick him. You went elsewhere. Is it in the back of your mind, though, that you might be back in that fight later down the line?
I think it's a fight that'll definitely happen in the future. Me and Liam are good guys with each other. We've talked about it and we've said it'll fight in the future. It'd be great to happen in this tournament, you know. Ideally, you'd love a final, wouldn't you? Me and him in the final, and a barnstormer like that again. But listen, Liam's a good guy, and I wish him all the best. And Saturday night.
Have you had a look at the other guys and maybe established who you see as the biggest threat to yourself in this tournament at all?
Nah, not really. That's not really my style. I just couldn't be annoyed using energy on it. I sound like a full hippie here, but I would just rather focus on the person in front of me. At the minute, Blachnik, he's the obstacle in front, and just go in and perform. I don't think it's about what he's going to do, i.e. watching him and what he does. I think for me, it's just about performing.
What does a win do for you at this point, Stephen, for your life, for your career, everything? What does it do for you?
Listen, I have three kids. There's not much this here wouldn't do, do you know what I mean? Three mouths to feed at home. But no, it's huge. MTK are literally just changing the landscape of boxing at the minute. The opportunities are coming up are ones that you hear whispers of but never materialise, where at the minute they're all happening.
Elsewhere on the card, we've got Dan Aziz in there with Lawrence Oswaki. I don't know if that's a fight that you've particularly seen much of either guy. Another good light heavyweight fight on the build-up. Have you seen much of either of them, and how do you expect it to play out?
Yeah, it's a good fight, I think. I always struggle to pronounce his second name, Oswaki. Yeah. He used to box in Oliver's with me years ago when I'd done my first year in Oliver's gym. He's a nice big fella, so I wish him well just because I know him.
Final one before I let you go, Stephen. I'm sure you're watching the boxing over the weekend. Anthony Joshua reclaiming the Unified Heavyweight Championship. Just get a reaction to that. Did you watch the fight? What did you make of his performance?
I think it was a good performance. I think it was, you know, it was what he needed to do. He went in, he boxed smart. He made a lot of money. He got a win, and he performed. What more do you ask of him? You know, why go into and beat the crowd all the time? Fair play to him.
Stephen, I'll leave the final word to you. What do we see from yourself Saturday night for those tuning in, for those coming down? What do they see?
Big performance.
Thank you very much for speaking to Boxing Social.